Hi, this is Charting Man Dan of thechartguys.com, home of technical analysis education. Click the link for a free week trial, no credit card required, and gain access to our multiple live broadcasts daily, community chat room, educational videos, nightly watch lists, and more. Invest in your education and future and join the community today. Hello everyone, looking at Apple on the daily, weekly, and shorter term time frame. So we've now consolidated 4 days in a row, but it is still normal, bullish, healthy consolidation, even though we're getting some short-term bearish indications. So those bearish indications are breaking from the higher low pattern. And if we look here, we saw a higher low of 116.78. We broke that yesterday, although we did still hold the 10-day moving average support, but now today we broke that 10-day moving average support and have lost it. And we're still pulling back, bearish MACD cross on the daily, indicating we're likely to pull back to test this middle Bollinger Band. Our next supports are this previous low of 115.72, and then the middle Bollinger Band will be catching up to that level the first few days of this coming week. It will be a red flag for the short-term bulls if we lose this middle Bollinger Band, but as of right now, still in control, and again, this big lower wick, a bit deceiving. The price did not drop that significantly that day. That was just a fluke trade showing up on the charts here. So it is normal, controlled, healthy consolidation. There was some pretty high volume the past 2 days, but you can see the lower wick on Thursday. Some of that was bullish action as we did close closer to the high of the day. And not a significant lower wick on Friday, but a little bit of that action was bulls buying the dip. So looking at Friday, or on the weekly, I should say, again, this lower wick is not that significant. It's just a little red consolidation week, lower high, and tightening up that range. And we can see last time we had a red week, and then it led to three green bull weeks and continuation to the upside. So I'm not seeing any red flags on the weekly trend that would indicate a change in that bullish sentiment. It's just the daily time frame looking like more consolidation is coming after losing the 10-day moving average support. And we'll see if the bulls can defend this 115.72 level, which would show the most strength. Another pattern I'm watching on the hourly time frame is the 100 and 200 period moving average creating a bit of a channel. So look on Thursday, rejecting from this level twice at the high of the day and then pulling back. And then on Friday, look where we bounced off the 200 period moving average support at the low of the day. So our channel is set right there. It's at 116.36 and 117.29, and they're going to get tighter and tighter as we move forward. So we'll have to see Monday pre-market where the price stands in regards to this channel. Let's zoom out to see the 5-day to get a little bit of a better grasp. So if we lose the 200 period, we know further downside likely coming. And if we turn this 100 period into support, we'll look to see if the bulls can potentially turn around that consolidation on the daily time frame and make a move back up towards 118 resistance. So we'll keep an eye on this hourly channel. I appreciate you watching, and we'll check back in on Monday. Have a great rest of your weekend.